Hi, and welcome to Jamie DeRoy and Friends. I'm Jamie DeRoy.
And I'm Barry Kleinbord.
To start us off this week, Harmony has opened on Broadway. The music is by Barry Manilow, the book and lyrics by Bruce Sussman, and it's choreographed and directed by Warren Carlyle.
And in the cast are Chip Zion, Julie Banco, and Sierra Bagas. And it's based on a true story about the comedian harmonists, a vocal group in Germany before World War II. So there's history on every front in this show.
Absolutely, and it's a story that is so important, especially today.
Another new hit on Broadway is the revival of Merrily We Roll Along, the musical which has a book by George Firth, music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim, and this revival being directed by Maria Friedman.
The cast boasts Daniel Radcliffe, Jonathan Groff, and Lindsay Mendez. It's playing at the Hudson Theater through March 24th. I just have to say that way back in the original production, which was 1981, my father invested a little bit of money in this. And unfortunately, that version did not have the success of this one.
I saw the second preview of Merrily, and by the end of the first act, half the audience had left. And every time a number finished, another section of the audience would leave. And I turned to the person I was next to and I said, "Are they giving out free beer in the lobby?" But it's so interesting how 40 years later, what the show is about seems to have hit the right moment in time.
Exactly. And everybody is loving this production. Now is your last chance to catch The Shark Is Broken on Broadway at the Golden Theater. It plays only through November 19th, and it boasts an incredible cast starring Ian Shaw, Alex Brightman, and Colin Donnell.
It's written by Ian Shaw and Joseph Nixon and directed by Guy Masterson. And it's about the making of Jaws, which was quite an experience.
And this is such a funny evening. You'll absolutely love it. Here's the look.
Quiet on set.
Camera. Rolling. Sound.
Speed.
Marker.
Scene 191D. Take two.
Action.
Let me tell you about the USS Indianapolis. It was 1945, Chief. Just left the island of Tinian. Lovely place, Chief.
Oh, for God's sake, I can't say this. It's duller than my tax return.
Dammit!
You are such a bad loser!
Dumb luck! If you think I'm letting you anywhere near my booze after that stunt you pulled!
Jesus Christ, Ryan, I don't have a death wish, okay? Just look, come on, I'm really good at finding stuff. Bingo!
Saints be praised! You're like a truffle pig boy!
I mean, they can put a man on the moon, they can't make a mechanical fish that floats.
I think we may have underestimated the power of the sea.
You know, it makes me think it would have been easier to just get a real shark.
You serious?
Sure, why not? Just get a tame shark. How hard can that be?
You ever seen a real live shark?
I'm from Queens, man. Of course I've never seen a real live shark.
Who gets top billing?
Your name is higher and it's in the middle!
But I am lower down and on the left.
My agent has screwed me again!
It's a thriller, a machine for making money. Do you really think they're gonna be talking about this in 50 years?
$50 at McDonald's. How many kids do you have?
9 so far.
You're gonna need a bigger boat. Sorry, I really love that line.
Melissa Etheridge, My Window, wraps up its run at the Circle in the Square also on November 19th. This singer-songwriter is so incredible and has a wonderful story. You're going to absolutely love it.
The autobiographical show is written by Melissa Etheridge and her partner, Linda Wallum Etheridge, and it's directed by Amy Tinkham.
Here's a look.
Come to my window, crawl inside, wait by the light of the moon. Come to my window, I'll be home soon.
There's another extension on Broadway, a hair extension. Jia Jia's African hair braiding has been extended to November 19th. It's written by Jocelyn Bio and it's directed by Whitney White.
It's playing at the Samuel J. Friedman Theater and it's presented by the Manhattan Theater Club. Here's a look.
Oh, it's just been one of those days already, you know? I slept through my alarm, which, like, I don't even know how that never happens to me. Then the hot water wasn't running in our building. And like, I know it's hot today, but not hot enough to just be taking a freezing cold shower, which I had to anyway. Then I threw on my clothes and ran out of the house. I get to the station, swipe my MetroCard, and of course, insufficient fare. Hey.
Oh. Afternoon, ladies, afternoon. I have some nice things for you ladies today. A ring, necklace, rings, bracelets, all the nice things. You want?
No, thank you.
And for you, beautiful Ndidi, how are you?
I'm fine, Olu. How are you?
Much better now that I'm basking in the light of your smile, Olu.
Thank you.
Here. I have something for you. Last time I was here, you mentioned you wanted some large hoops. So, I went and had these made for you. They even dipped in 14 karat gold since I know you have sensitive skin.
Really?
Of course.
Oh, these are beautiful.
For you? Only the best.
Shucked has announced its closing, and that will be on January 14th of next year. So you have some time to catch this incredibly funny show. It's playing at the Niederlander, directed by Jack O'Brien.
The book is by Robert Horn, and the score is by Brandy Clark and Shane McAnally.
And it stars Tony Award winner Alex Newell,
fantastic,
who won for Featured Actor in a Musical.
The way history is written, jump into the first Thanksgiving. The Indians brought something they called maize.
Ah, maize!
Around 1130, the pilgrims stuffed a turkey, slipped into a tryptophanic haze.
With leftovers for days and days of corn.
Philip Roth's scandalous novel, Sabbath's Theater, has been adapted for the stage by John Turturro and Ariel Levy and directed by Joe Bonney, and it's currently playing off-Broadway.
It's over at the Pershing Square Signature Theater on West 42nd Street. And the cast is John Turturro, Elizabeth Marvel, and Jason Kravitz.
It runs till December 3rd.
The only man she would ever admit to having charge for the night was the puppeteer Sabbath, when I negotiated a threesome with a German au pair.
Cash, crisp bills, stiff and new.
How many?
Oh,
10.
I can't afford 10.
Well, forget it then. Leave me out.
You're a hard woman.
Yes, hard. I have a sense of my worth.
It's taken some doing to arrange this, you know. It's not been a snap setting this threesome up. It's I who want to be paid by you.
$1,000 or I stay home.
Oh, you're asking the impossible.
Never mind then.
500.
750.
500 is the best I can do.
Then I must have it all before we get there. I want to walk in with the money in my purse feeling like I have a job to do. Take her head between my hands and kiss her right on the mouth. I want to feel like a real whore.
Oh, I doubt to feel like a real whore. Money alone will suffice.
Oh, it will for me.
Lucky you.
Lucky you!
Eric Tucker's Bedlam Theater is presenting Tom Stoppard's Arcadia at the West End Theater.
Until December 3rd. And I want to tell you, Jamie, this Tom Stoppard play changed my life. And I saw it first in London, and then I saw it when Lincoln Center did it. And I'm so looking forward to seeing this production because this play made me think about life in a way that I had never thought about before. And I think that the theater is glorious when it can do that. And this play can do that.
I agree, and we saw it together.
We saw it together. And I remember before the lights went down, you turned to me and you said, am I going to understand this? And I said, uh-huh.
And I did.
And you did.
We beg you to see any Bedlam production. They are
right.
So creative. We just adore the Bedlam Theater.
Right, and they're doing a worthy play.
Down at the DR2 Theater through January 7th is All the Devils Are Here, How Shakespeare Created the Villain. Patrick Page developed this play and he stars in it. It's a one-person show, one act, directed by Simon Godwin, and it is terrific. Just to hear Patrick Page's voice for 90 minutes is a pure heaven.
Through December 3rd, the Irish Rep is doing a revival of Brian Friel's play, Translations. It's directed by Doug Hughes. And Brian Friel, again, is an important playwright who we just don't see enough these days.
And you know, everything I see at the Irish Rep is terrific. So try to get down there and just see every production they do, but especially Translations.
I'm with Jamie.
Classic Stage Company presents a revival of I Can Get It For You Wholesale.
Right. This Broadway musical appeared in 1962. It has music and lyrics by Harold Rome and a book by Jerome Wideman. This version has been newly adapted by Wideman's son, John Wideman. It's directed by Trip Cullman. And in the cast, we have Santino Fontana and Judy Kuhn.
One of my favorite things to do in New York is go to Carnegie Hall and see the New York Pops under the direction of Maestro Stephen Reinecke. On November 17th, it presents An Evening with Sutton Foster and Kelly O'Hara.
That's a dynamic duo, wouldn't you say?
I would say two Tony Award winners.
Indeed.
Now for our cabaret roundup. At 54 Below, Seth Sykes brings his new show to the club on November 21st. Here is a look at the always delightful Seth Sykes.
I'm nobody's baby. I wonder why each night and day I pray the Lord up above, please send me down somebody to love. But nobody wants me. I'm blue somehow. Won't someone hear my plea and take a chance with me? Because I'm nobody's baby now. Believe me. No, nobody's baby. And I've got to know the reason why. Last week I was chatting on an app and met a chap and I said, hey, maybe I was meant for you. But before he blocked me, he so rudely said, I wish we'd met when you were 22. Oh, nobody wants me. I'm mighty blue. somehow, won't someone hear my plea and take a little chance with me? Because I'm no nobody's baby like I once was. Won't someone hear my plea and take a chance with me? Because I'm trying, I'm crying, I'm lonesome, all my own some. I don't mean maybe I'm nobody's baby, 'cause nobody once it was.
On November 29th, Anthony Nunziata brings his new show, My Italian Broadway Christmas, to 54 Below.
Here's a look.
Christmas time makes me sentimental. Feels old-fashioned, yet it feels brand new. And every time it rolls around, the streets are filled with joyful sounds, and my heart is full of so many wishes too. What I wish for at Christmas, for the world, not just for me, is the peace that comes from deep inside, where you're safe and loved and free. And though I might be a dreamer, I am also living proof that miracles can happen, because with you the greatest wish came true. Winter snow is falling on the trees. Can't you see the lights are shining red and green? Angels are singing, jingle bells are ringing, and there's a star for all to see. What I wish for at Christmas, for the world, not just for me, is the peace that comes from deep inside, where you're safe and loved and free. And though I might be a dreamer, I am also living proof that miracles can happen, because with you the greatest wish came true. Just for me is the peace that comes from deep inside, where you're safe and loved and free. And though I might be a dreamer, I am also living proof that miracles can happen, because with you, greatest wish came true.
David Sabella brings his character Amanda Reckonwith to Pangaea on November 18th and December 16th. On Monday, December 4th, Ben Jones appears at Birdland in his tribute to Frank Sinatra called Let Me Be Frank. Jamie, I hear there's a new theater in town.
Yes, the Perlman Performing Arts Center, PAC NYC. It's open downtown, and it is thrilling to have a new theater in town.
I agree. Let's take a look.
When New York City faces adversity, New Yorkers don't pull back. They look forward. When someone said that Lower Manhattan's best days were behind us, others had a vision of the future. A neighborhood with more residents and businesses than before, and millions of visitors, and a memorial, and a museum, and an arts center like no other in the world. When New York City faces adversity, New Yorkers don't let down. They build up.
A groundbreaking and state-of-the-art performing arts center is rising in downtown Manhattan. This building is the final piece of the master plan for the reconstruction of the World Trade Center. The building, designed by the acclaimed architecture firm Rex, appears beautiful and deceptively simple. But this building is so much more. Creating New York City's newest performing arts center required feats of engineering, design, and technology. What you see as solid marble is actually a translucent skin made of thousands of thinly sliced marble tiles, layered between insulating and protective glass panels. Cut from a mega block of marble, the 5,000 chosen tiles are each 5 by 3 feet and 12 millimeters thick. Each exquisitely veined marble tile precisely bookmatched to form a pattern on the facade that is symmetrical, both horizontally and vertically. And while each tile is unique, the patterns they form are identical on every side. The first engineering challenge was to build on top of a busy transit hub that ties 13 subway and path lines together, as well as a network of underground services and structures for the World Trade Center. The building literally sits on top of all this sight and transit infrastructure, supported by 7 strategically engineered super columns. Above ground, it rests on a base of granite, and while subways rumble below, the building's design provides acoustic isolation for performances above. Let's peek inside to preview those performance spaces. What makes the Performing Arts Center so exciting is the automation built in. Stages are able to change shape, size, and location. Walls come up and down, and seating platforms easily move, all to create the most exciting, dynamic performing arts space New York City has ever seen. This intimate theater in the round transforms effortlessly into a larger theater, with stage and seats moving in. Blink again, and seating rises upward, and the stage reconfigures for yet another perspective for audiences and artists. With one more wall removed, what was once 3 theaters becomes a grand concert hall, acoustically adjusted and ready for an artistic breakthrough. The marble provides dynamism outside and in. In daylight from the outside, the marble is respectful and beautiful. As the sun leaves the sky, the marble begins to glow. An effect that, when seen from inside, up close and lit by the sun, reveals the true drama and depth of the stone. Opening in September 2023, the Performing Arts Center will be a beautiful tribute to a uniquely special site and a dynamic place to experience the arts and entertainment.
A huge congratulations to Wicked, playing on Broadway for 20 years at the Gershwin Theater. at the same theater. Sometimes they move around, not this one.
Not this time. It has music and lyrics by Stephen Schwartz, a book by Winnie Holtzman, choreography by Wayne Cilento, and it's directed by Joe Mantello.
It is still pleasing audiences you can't believe. Here is a look at Broadway's favorite, Wicked.
Wicked.
Becoming popular. There is or was ever.